It's our 20th year anniversary show, Fred. 20 years!
20 years!
We're still alive! But you know what, Fred? We got a lot of comedians tonight. Yeah. We have a singer, Raquel Raines, is in the house tonight, Saturday. Yeah, yeah. But you know what, Fred? I was driving home one day, and I hit a pig.
I hit a pig.
Oh, while I was driving. So, you know, without thinking, I said, well, I better call the police. So I called up, and they said, whatever you do, don't leave, because it's a $300 fine to hit livestock in this state. So, I said, well, let me leave. So I went to work. But I get to work, and there's a police officer there. And he gives me a $300 ticket, Fred.
$300?
$300,
yeah.
Lucky So I get the ticket. So I asked the cop, I said, how did you find out where I am? And he said, it was the pig. Squealed.
Squealed,
Fred, squealed. All right, Fred, we got a lot of comedians tonight. What? We got singers, we got everything.
Wow.
All right, so with that, Freddie Coscia, take it away.
Yeah.
Raquel Raines is my co-host slash singer tonight.
Yes, thank you for having me.
From the last show. You were here doing the running song the last show, right?
Me and Fred's song.
Yes, yes, nice. Okay.
Yep.
And we have a lot of comedians tonight, so we got to get going. This is the special 20th year anniversary show.
Wow, congratulations.
But first, I have to give a shout out. I have somebody that passed away that was in the comedy world. He was a really good friend of mine, and he owned two comedy clubs in New York City, Broadway Comedy Club. His name was Al Martin, and he was a co-host for this show.
Oh.
And I just want to dedicate this show to Al Martin. He was a great friend of mine, and he always said, keep the show going.
Mm.
So with that said, let's on with the show. And our first guest is PJ. PJ, how you doing? PJ Morin?
PJ Morin.
Morin. How you doing, PJ?
I'm doing fan-diddly-tastic. I'm very glad to be here. Thank you for having me on. This is a lovely studio.
Okay, awesome, awesome. Where are you from?
I'm from Cranford, New Jersey.
Okay, how long have you been doing comedy?
Doing comedy for about 3 years. I started when I was a senior in high school.
Nice, nice. What made you get into comedy?
Listen, man, when I was a kid, I didn't have Netflix. I just had On Demand. So I just watched Jack Black, Adam Sandler, and Kevin James all the time. And Robin Williams.
Robin
Williams and Jack Black. If you couldn't tell by the hair, I like Jack Black.
Right.
We rock the D.
You're kind of similar looking, right?
I appreciate it. That's what I go for.
Okay. All right, and what are some of the dumbest misadventures you have been on?
About 2 weeks ago, I can't go into detail, but I was tricked into going to see Caucus with a friend of mine. No, it was Hackensack. He said he missed a doctor's appointment. And it wasn't a doctor's appointment. I can't elaborate. I was at a swingers convention this weekend to do comedy.
Oh, yeah.
That one's probably more important. I got a phone call one day, and he said, hey, man, there's going to be a bunch of naked people, and you're going to do jokes, and you get a room for free for the weekend. Okay. I said, I'm a comedian and a college student, pal. I'm double broke. I'll take a free vacation and get naked.
Right. So you do swing?
No, not at the moment. But listen, they're cool people and I love them.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
I aim to be the king of the swingers one day.
All right.
They call me Tarzan.
Okay. Where can people find you and stuff?
YouTube, PJ Morin, Instagram, the PJ Morin, all around New Jersey, New Brunswick, Garwood, Hackensack, Woodbridge, New York sometimes, Pennsylvania sometimes. I have a radio show on Governor's Comedy Club, Jersey Stench.
Oh, okay.
That's a fun one.
Oh, nice, nice.
Yeah, I'm everywhere. I'm busy, but I love it.
So you're on Facebook, Instagram?
Everything.
Okay.
Yeah, everything is the PJ Morin.
Okay, and they can find your schedule and stuff on that
No, I keep, no. I keep myself. Well, yeah, they can find my comedy schedule everywhere. Oh,
okay. Do you have a set for us?
I do have a set for you.
Okay. All right. PJ Morin, so ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Freddie. That was beautiful. We'll keep it going for Freddie, guys. This guy's playing the drums like a madman. How are we doing, Staten Island? We doing good? That's wonderful. Listen, my friend Eric reached out to me to come onto this thing. And he said, hey, listen, but it has to be like a PG-13, you know, ish set. You know, it's going to be on public access TV. Can't get super dirty. And I said, okay. And he was like, oh, but do a bunch of your impressions. And he was like, do that Italian guy. They love that. And I said, do that Italian guy, but clean.
Guys, listen, doing Tony Soprano freaking clean sounds really freaking stupid. It doesn't sound freaking good, but I did find out there's some words I can get away with on public access. I can say, God damn it. I can say, bitch. And to end it, I can say, penis.
I walked in here, I said, hey, man, what words can I get away with? And he gave me a list, and I said, good, I'll do all of them. it's fun. What's it called? Yeah, Nevin heard I was doing a Trump impression, and he said, hey, man, watch out. We don't get political on here. And I said, I'm going to ruin your show tonight. No, I'm kidding. But no, you guys want to hear a Trump impression?
Yeah.
You guys hear a Trump impression? All right. So, guys, listen, you know how Donald Trump got that small loan of $1 million for his dad when he was younger? Well, you know, what if instead of going into real estate and running America, he instead bought out the band America? Made himself the lead singer? So I feel like that's on brand. It's something he'd do, right?
Definitely.
Like, I just like you to imagine me living that multiverse. You're getting out of your house in the morning. It's cold or warm. It's July. You're tired. You don't want to go to work. It's a Tuesday. You get in your car. You turn on your radio. And all you hear is, quite frankly, I've been to the desert on a horse with no name. No name at all. Not good. It felt great to be out of the rain, okay, in the desert. You can't remember your name, cause there ain't no one for it to give you no pain. No pain at all. Not good. Da 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 da. Trump for you guys. There we go. Thank you, Fred. I love this man. God, listen, I walked in here, I looked at Fred, and I said, okay, so I do have hope for the future. But listen, if we lived in that timeline, that Trump song would go at the top of each and every one of my playlists, because that's a banger. Followed closely by Piano Man, by former President Barack Obama. My fellow Americans, sing us a song. The Piano Man. Sing us a song tonight, because we're all in the mood for a melody, and my fellow Americans, you got us feeling all right. La 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 la. Piano Man, Obama. There we go.
Obama.
I'm gonna keep this short and sweet. But would you guys like one more presidential impression before I get out of here? Would you guys like one more? All right, guys. This is my I honestly haven't even done this one yet, guys. I've been working really hard on this one. This is my Joe Biden impression.
No.
Joe Biden, everybody!
Wow, that was funny.
That was good.
Our next comedian is Jen.
Oh.
Hi.
Hi, Jen.
Hello.
Thank you for being here. You look lovely.
Thank you. I am so excited to be here on this 20th anniversary. I was so excited to be asked. Thank you for having me on.
Jen, what's your last name? What's Southern?
My last name is Snorteland.
Snorteland. Yeah, but how can I forget Snorteland?
Don't worry, though. I did get married. My husband's last name is Keepler, like the elf. So I thought, you know, we'll do Snorteland Keepler, but we sounded kind of like a cocaine elf law firm. So we gave that up, and I was like, you know, let me just keep with Snorteland since I've had it for so long.
It's nice. Where are you from, Miss Snorteland?
I am from Nassau County, Long Island.
Okay, cool. How long have you been doing comedy?
So it's a little bit of a loaded question. I went to a magnet high school for musical theater.
Oh.
So I had 5 years of that where I studied comedy. Then after I had my daughter much later in life, once you have a child, a lot of my moms can relate, you kind of want to do something for you, something to get yourself back, you know, instead of being mommy all the time. So I decided to give it a go, and I did some studying, brushed up on it, and hit the stage, and here I am. So, I mean, I'm doing something right.
I love that. So that is really great.
Oh, thank you, but keep going. Let's
go. So what made you get into comedy then?
You know, as a kid, and just everything through life, especially living, you know, I was born in the mid-80s, there's been so much trauma that we've been through, right? And how do you deal with that as a kid? You make fun of it. You absolutely make fun of it, especially when you're growing up in the 80s and you have movies like RoboCop and you've got movies like Ghostbusters and you have Dan Aykroyd and all the Second City guys. I mean, they made everything funny and nothing was off limits and it was hysterical. I remember faking sick so I could watch Gallagher jump on that couch on HBO. I know some of you guys know what I'm talking about. And then later in life, you get to actually see these legends on stage. They tour. And I was, and it was magical and incredible. So I did get to meet Gallagher.
Cool.
The real Gallagher.
Wow.
He told me to shut up. Oh. But it absolutely destroyed me. Totally true story. But it was so great to see him live. And you know, comedy is one of those things that, as far away as it is, it's always accessible to everybody.
That's beautiful. I have one more question for you. Do you hate it when someone asks you to say something funny?
I actually love that. Number one, because they're like, there's Jen, she's funny. And number two, people are like, oh, I don't like that. It's like monkey dance. You know what? Monkey dance. You know, absolutely.
Okay.
If they ask me to say a joke, I'll key one up. I'll key one up. Or I might even try something new on somebody and be like, what do you think about that, huh?
Okay, where can we find you then to ask you?
I actually do have a show on YouTube as well called The Wine Down.
Okay.
Where I work with a sommelier and we review liquor and wine and have special guests.
That's really cool.
Soon. Ooh. So we do that. And then also you can find me all over Long Island. I tend to stay in Long Island and New York because I do have a young daughter. And I do a lot of charity work as well. So you can find me a lot of benefits. I'm actually going to be doing the NASA Suffolk Autism Society of America's benefit
Beautiful.
In September.
Great.
So super looking forward to all of that.
Yay. Well.
Okay. Well, you have a set for us?
Yeah.
Okay.
Woo!
That lovely intro. You can bang my drum anytime. I was so excited to get this to get this invitation. Thank you so much, Nevin. I mean, 20 years of doing this YouTube, this public access show for Staten Island. I didn't even know Staten Island had electricity for 20 years. This is so exciting. So as I mentioned before, I'm a mom and I am so lucky because was that you? That was a guy, but that's cool. We're with it. I'm a mom, and I'm so lucky. I live so close to my mother. But we don't always see eye to eye. So she comes up to me one day, and she says, Jennifer, your daughter, she watches way too many cartoons, too much screen time. I say, who are you to judge me? You bought my baby blanket with Marlboro Miles. I tell you what, I was the only kid in the park. I just looked like a big pack of cigarettes. My dad, he was so embarrassed. He wanted the pizza stone. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, it is tough out there. I am so glad to be married and not be in the dating scene using all those weird apps, Tinder, Match, Snatched. I'm done with it. I'm, believe it or not, somebody married this, all right? And I love my husband, but the first time I went back to his apartment, I walked into the house and he had no TV. Even Jeffrey Dahmer had a TV. So I ask him, I say, what are we gonna do? And he looks at me and he says, you know what we're gonna do. Mm-hmm. 2 days later, he bought a 65-inch flat screen.
Nice.
Being married, though, is absolutely fantastic. And my husband, he is definitely my better half, absolutely 100%. He is a two-time veteran of foreign war. Thank you. Woo! Thank you. Yes, very proud. Very proud. So basically, I am the worst. But my husband's absolutely phenomenal. And he comes up to me recently, and with everything going on, he says, you know, Jen, I think I'm going to re-enlist. And I said, are you nuts? Are you out of your mind? For how long? And he said, until your mother moves out. Take me with you. What are you doing? So I really try to get on my husband's level because he's been through so much, you know? So I ask him one day, I say, babe, tell me about your worst day. And he looked me right in the eye and he said, our wedding? That's about me. Terrible, terrible, terrible. But being married is kind of like, it's kind of like an Amelia Bedelia situation. I don't know if you guys read that book, but she'd be like, dress the chickens, meaning like put dressing on them, but then she would actually like put clothes on the chickens. So I come home one day, and I find my husband in the foyer, completely naked, like this. And I say, babe, what are you doing? And he said, you told me to do this. Hmm? I said, honey, I said, wind the clock. It is tough. It is tough. Something I also do on the side is I am a paranormal investigator. This is true. Absolutely true. Yeah, I have the equipment and everything. So I know this is Staten Island, but has anyone here ever heard of Kings Park? Kings Park, Pilgrim State? You've heard of Pilgrim State? Sir, you look fantastic. I'm so glad they let you out. You look lovely. Somebody go get him out of here. But I did go to Pilgrim State, and I had all my best equipment. You know, I had the EVP reader, the EMF reader, and my brand new XG350 laser grid machine. And I stood there all night. I didn't catch a single ghost. But I did get one roach clip, a broken bong, and found a new dealer. Thanks. So speaking of drugs, a few days ago, my niece came up to me and she said, Aunt Jen, there's a boy at school and he's trying to sell me a baggie of marijuana for $50. I said, that's absolutely disgusting. That's $20. Someone's trying to roll my niece.
Right.
It's terrible. Also, that's my turf. I need a cut of that. So yeah, you know, my husband, he's a sensible one, right? He's an accountant. So one day he comes to me and he says, Jen, I think you drink too much. And I had to believe him because he's the sensible guy. And I said, what do you think I should do? And he said, you should get a sponsor. You should get a sponsor. So I did. Visit sipandsay.com and use code THEWINDOWN for 15% off your liquor purchases. Thank you guys so much. Happy 20th anniversary.
Woo! Wow, that was awesome. Okay. Okay, so you're going to sing a song for us?
Yes, I would love to.
Okay.
Here I go.
There you go. It's Raquel Rains.
When I was young, I'd listen to the radio, waiting for my favorite songs. When they played, I'd sing along. It'd make me smile. Those were such happy times, and not so long ago. How I wondered where they'd gone, but they're back again, just like a long lost friend. All the songs I love so well. Every sha-la-la-la, every whoa-whoa still shines. Every shing-a-ling-a-ling that they're starting to sing so fine. When they get to the part where he's breaking her heart, it can really make me cry, just like before. It's yesterday once more. Looking back on times and then the years went by, and the good times that I had makes today seem rather sad. So much has changed. It was songs of love that I would sing to then, and I'd memorize each word. Those old melodies still sound so good to me as they melt the years away. Every sha-la-la-la, every whoa-whoa still shines.
All the oldies but goodies.
Every shing-a-ling-a-ling that they're starting to sing so fine. All my best memories come back clearly to me. Some can even make me cry, just like before. It's yesterday once more. Every shing-a-ling-a-ling that they're starting to sing so fine. Every sha-la-la-la, every whoa-whoa still shines. So fine. Every sha-la-la-la.
All right, that was awesome.
Thank you.
Okay, our next comedian is Joe. Joe, how do you do?
How you doing?
Good,
how you
good.
Nice to be here in Staten
Island. Susquehanna hats. Remember Susquehanna hats?
Oh, yeah.
You got that at Bagel Street, right?
No.
So, Joe, what's your last name?
Borzotta.
Borzotta. Joe Borzotta. Okay. Where are you from, Joe?
Right now I'm living down by Ocean Township near Asbury Park, Jersey Shore.
Oh, cool. What made, how long have you been doing comedy?
About 5 years, give or take.
Okay, cool.
You know.
And what made you get into comedy?
Well, it was kind of a bucket list thing. I had open heart surgery a while ago, and I made a little bucket list of certain things to do, and this was one of them. And you know, I did it. I was supposed to be one and done. And I did it a couple months later. I'm like, yeah, I could have done that, but, you know. Let me do one more time, and then now here we are.
And you got the bug. You got the itch.
I got the bug.
Okay. If you got hired for a late night talk show, who would you invite as your first guest, and why?
Jack Nicholson.
No, that's a good one, but no. I think my pick would be Peter O'Toole. I think he's the best talk show host ever. I don't know if he's still alive even, but he was great because he always came out and he told these incredible stories with that great way of speaking he had. And every story he told started out with, you know, Richard Harris and I were drunk. And then it was just comedy gold after that. Fantastic.
He was good.
The best.
What advice can you give aspiring comedians?
I'd say, number one, record everything you do and edit ruthlessly and write. Second, I would say, if there's other comics whose work you like, ask them for input. And lastly, find another gig.
Okay. And where can people find you?
I'm on Instagram and Facebook, and I'm one half of Ugly Pancake Productions. We do a lot of comedy shows. Wow. That's on Instagram also.
I'm getting hungry just thinking about it. Yeah, my pancakes. Okay. All right, you have a set for us?
Yes, sure do.
Okay.
Island, how you doing, everybody? Like you said, my name's Joe Borzotta. My friends call me Joey B. You might know my brother Hepatitis. or my sister Cardi. I'm leaving the house to come here tonight. My wife goes, break a leg. I'm like, oh, thank you, honey. She goes, no, seriously, I hope you fall off that stage and break your leg. We had such a big argument. You know, I'm like walking out the house. She's yelling at me. She's like, I hope you die a slow, painful death. And I was like, so wait, are you saying you want me to stay? Things changed after 12 years. Things changed, you know? Like, when we first got married, she used to come to bed in, like, Victoria's Secret lingerie. Nice, right? Now she comes to bed, big gray sweatpants, a big gray hoodie. I feel like I married Rocky Balboa. I remember his little manager, Mickey. You know, when she comes into bed, she transforms into him and starts yelling at me, stay on your side of the bed or I'll knock you out. Boy, I'm telling you. So, it's great to be back in the New York area. I used to live in Manhattan. Now I'm trapped in suburban hell in boring Jersey. Now the most exciting part of my day is trying to figure out which neighbor's dog took a dump on my lawn. My dog's a freak. My dog's a freak. She sniffs out the dog's pee like a sommelier sniffing wine. Cocker Spaniel, 2009. I don't know. Any dog owners here? Any dog owners? You know when you got to pick up that steaming pile of poop with the plastic bag on your hands? In the winter, doesn't it make a great hand warmer? I'm going to do a quick impression for you. This is my dog as a stand-up comic. Good evening. My life is rough. Thank you. Oh, man. I know I sound cranky, but completing my picture of suburban hell is, you know, wife, house, dog. I got a kid. My son's 10 years old. My son, Rocco. And he's a wise guy. He's into the knock-knock jokes. You know, like, you be me, I'll be the kid, all right? Hey, Daddy, knock-knock.
Who's there?
I make more money in 1 week with my YouTube channel than you make in a whole year doing stand-up comedy. Oh my God, that's very clever. It's very funny. Now go make your own breakfast. Oh, what else is going on? You know, the kids today, it's weird, like with the sports, right? Nowadays, it's so different. Every single kid on every single team gets a trophy. A participation trophy. Yeah. When I played baseball, my first year, we were the worst team ever. Remember the Bad News Bears? We were the piece of crap Bears. And back then, only the team that came in first place got trophies. It was rough back then. You know, the rest of us, all we got were big buttons with the letter L for loser on it. And you have the parents these days today, you know? Everything with the helmet. Kids got to wear a helmet doing everything. We didn't wear helmets when I was a kid, and we used to do some crazy evil Knievel stuff, you know? Like, let's pile a big pile of rocks and broken glass and make a ramp and jump our bikes over it.
I must have fallen and crashed my head 100 times. I can still count to K. I know, I'm starting to sound like a cranky old man, but I am a middle-aged. I can't deny it, I am. I'll give you an example, all right? I used to, I have a friend, Paulie. I've known him for over 20 years, right? So 20 years, if I call Paulie, hey, Paulie, what's going on this weekend? Yo, Joey B, we're going down to the Jersey Shore. There's gonna be women. There's gonna be booze. We're gonna party like it's 1999. Hell yeah! Thank you. I gotta catch my breath after that. Now, 20 years later, I call Paulie. We're middle-aged. Paulie, what's going on this weekend? Friday, I have to go for a colonoscopy. Saturday, I have to go to Home Depot and buy rope and mulch. Bags and bags and bags and bags and bags and bags of mulch to mulch my yard with mulch. And then Sunday, I'm going to get up and take that rope and hang myself. Thank you, everybody. It's an honor to be here. 20 years, 20th anniversary. Cheers.
That was really good.
Yes, it was.
My face is hurting from laughing so much. Okay, our next comedian.
Yes.
Is Allison.
Hi, Allison.
Hi,
how
are you doing?
Doing well. Where are you from?
I'm also from Long Island.
Okay. How long have you been doing comedy?
I will be doing it 3 years in August, so I'm like a newbie.
All right.
And Allison, what's your last name?
Perski.
Perski. Okay.
I know, like purse and key.
Purse key? Oh, purse. We have a key tonight.
I know. Okay. He's not my husband.
Okay. What made you get into comedy?
So I just like to blab a lot on Facebook, and people thought it was funny. So they were like, all right, maybe you should try this out. It's a whole different world doing it on Facebook than it is doing stand-up. Mm-hmm. So there have been a lot of, you know, editing and hardships, and you know, some days you love it, some days you just never want to do it again, but it's definitely something different. And like Jen said, I'm a mom, so it's something different to do. Instead of like wiping my kids' butts, I do this.
Okay, last question for you. What's the best or worst prank you've played on someone, or someone played on you?
So I like pranking my kids on April Fool's Day. So the first one I did, my older one was potty training. And so I was screaming, someone pooped on the toilet, someone pooped. And he was like crying, he's like, I promise I didn't. And then he walked in and there was poop balloons everywhere. And then this year it just happened to fall on when the kids were off. So like they were half asleep. And I woke them up. I'm like, we have to go. I had my friend call in the most ridiculous, obnoxious voice, like, this is the school secretary. School is on. And my kids almost killed me. It was a good one, though.
Where can people find you?
Oh, so Facebook. I'm also on Instagram. Everything is Allison Perski. I do shows in Long Island. I'm actually in a contest for Mohegan Sun. That'll be the end of June. So.
Okay, great.
Yeah. It'll be nice if I get through.
Do you have a set for us?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Okay. Allison.
How's everyone doing tonight? Woo. Are we all getting ready for summer? Getting ready for that summer body?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
I decided I need to make a few changes, so I started cooking with hate. Not one person noticed. I knew I needed to start losing weight when I went to the pharmacy with my husband. We went to get KY jelly. He was so excited. I'm like, relax, I need something to get this wedding ring off. So So it's fun being married, right? If you like being berated. My husband likes to tell me I am like a unicorn, and I thought it was because I was so rare and special. But it's because I have a unibrow. So. But it's, you know, not all bad with him. He was away the last couple of days, and I really missed him. I had to start slapping my own ass. So I like to, you know, I'm a mom of two young kids, so I like to do things that are different, like comedy, right? So sometimes when I'm out, people are like, oh, well, you know, maybe you should be doing something a little more prosperous at night. And what's the most prosperous thing you can do at night? Hook it. All right, let me break it down for you. I have to be up here for 6 minutes. Most guys only need 2 to 3. But, you know, I don't want you to think that all moms are boring. Yes, I do stand up, but I also hang out with my friends. I can call some of my mommy friends up and they make a party out of anything. Here's how it goes. Ring, ring. This is obviously fiction because no one answers their phone, but just go with me here. Ring, ring. Hello. There is a gang fight outside. Oh, my God. Will there be themed cocktails? Blue Lagoons for the Crips, Bloody Marys for the Bloods. I'm in. But it's funny because once us moms do get out, it's like we don't know how to handle the freedom. We turn into the children we're caring for. We stumble while we walk. We drink till we puke. We put anything in our mouths. But we deserve it, though, because being a mom is the hardest job in the world. Come on, guys, don't be ungrateful. It was just Mother's Day. Did we already forget? So I have a 10 and a 6-year-old, and they always want me to play with them. But whenever I do, they're always whining. But, Mommy, we don't want to play Mahjong. I dropped my older one off for a play date, and when I went to pick him up, the mother was so nasty. I'm like, what's the problem? She's like, you dropped him off 3 days ago. And my little one, I'm trying to potty train my little one at night. This way he can potty train me during the day. I feel so bad for my husband. Between my two boys who don't know what a toilet seat is and me who doesn't believe in Kegels, there's pee everywhere. My husband walks into Penn Station. He sniffs around. He goes, home sweet home. So I hate people that don't RSVP. Ooh. At my wedding, this woman just showed up. I was going to go off on her, and then I let it go. But then she caught the bouquet, and I lost my mind. I stormed up to her. I'm like, you owe me $200 for the plate. Back at the hotel, my husband could tell I was upset. And he's like, why? Because you embarrassed yourself? I'm like, no, because she put $500 in the envelope. And I should have never spoken to your mother like that. But I don't know. I don't understand people that don't get along with their mother-in-laws. I get along with my mother-in-law so well that my husband could just be out of the picture. I just want her. I feel like it's like this. There's really nothing more redeeming than hearing someone's own mother call their sweet angel pie a putz. Like, there's really nothing better than that. So I'm actually originally from Queens, New York. Give it up. And I moved to Long Island, and it's so different here. Like, people will go to the store. They'll be like, do you need anything? Do you need milk? Do you need a ride somewhere? Back at Queens, I never even spoke to my neighbors. They would see me being, like, in a gurney being rolled out, and they'd be like, oh, are you gonna need your parking spot? So again, 20 years, give it up. I really didn't think I was gonna make it here tonight because my babysitter said she was hungover, she was drinking and partying, dancing all night. I really can't stand my mother-in-law sometimes. Let's hear it for your host.
All right. That was great. Awesome. That was very funny. We're moving right along.
Mm-hmm.
So our next comedian is Eric Seltzer. How you doing, Eric?
Seltzer.
How you doing? Good. So Eric, where are you from? You're from Staten Island, right?
Well, I grew up in Jersey. I live 15 minutes from here in Staten Island. Yes.
Oh, nice. Hey, finally, Fred, a Staten Islander.
Just until you didn't get my joke. You said it's Eric Seltzer. I says, oh, just in time for a Coke.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah. Okay.
That's why you're still on the Staten Island comedy show.
Right. Okay, Eric, how long have you been doing comedy?
Since 2006, I performed at Caroline's from a comedy class I took.
Oh, yeah? Oh,
and
wow.
I performed
was
at Caroline's.
Sweet?
Caroline's, right?
Sweet. Yeah.
So what made you get into comedy? I think I asked you last time, but...
I was an odd kid. I was very shy in school, but going on stage, I was a good class clown. Uh-huh. At the end of the class, the teacher let me go up and impersonate them. They were, like, amazed, so... I like being a center of attention. Mm-hmm. It was easier to do it like that and just continue adult life.
Yeah, all right. What's the silliest thing you are pretty good at?
Hit it, Fred.
All right.
That's pretty good.
Very much.
And Eric, where do you see yourself in 5 years?
I see myself either in with a movie career or on an ensemble of a TV show.
Okay, cool. And you were in the very famous The Devil Wears Prada movie.
Yes,
right?
I played Anne Hathaway's driver Roy.
Nice.
In that movie, yes. Right, I was also a detective on Blue Bloods, episode. Let's see, season 10, episode 3.
Nice.
And I was in Law & Order. Well, if you check out my reel, Eric Seltzer Actor, you can see all those clips.
Wow, Fred, a real star on the Staten Island Comedy Show.
You forgot the Coca-Cola, though.
Are you sponsoring Coca-Cola? I mean...
With that, where can people find you?
In a nut house.
Right. Eric Seltzer Actor. Or, I used to perform with Jody on her show.
Oh, yeah, Jody, yeah.
Too bad she's not
with us anymore. Right.
But, I'm on all over YouTube, and I'm waiting for a couple of parts. Fingers crossed.
All right.
Okay. I'm not going to say what they are because if I don't get the part, I don't have to look like a jerk.
Okay, break a leg on that and break a leg on this. You want to do a set for us?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. All right. Eric!
Very good. Yeah, two.
Do I remember? Too bad the show just got canceled.
Too late for that one.
So, my name is Eric Seltzer, and I've been married to the same woman in August for 32 years. Thank you. You know, I'll tell you, there's only really one thing missing being married that long. Free will. But I'll tell you, my wife and I are very different. I mean, she's a clean freak, I'm not. For instance, I get up in the morning, I'm the last one out of bed, and she'll say, your pillows are not adjusted properly. I'm like, is the photo shoot for House and Garden magazine at 10 or 10:30? And since I'm the last one in the kitchen, and I clean, anyone will think the kitchen looks clean. She'll say, why is this smudge on the table? I'm like, I don't know, human error. And when she, you know, my wife's favorite hobby is shopping. For instance, let's call the store C. Hay Hacks, because I can't say the actual store. We'll go there on the weekend, and, you know, me, I find what I want in 20 minutes. I try it on, I'm done. She will stay in the same store for 3 hours. So I'm the schmuck husband that sits in the home section, and thank God they have internet on the phone, because let me tell you, it wouldn't be fun sitting catatonic staring at socks and underwear. Anyway, picture us 100 years ago on the Titanic. I'm like, oh my God, the ship just hit an iceberg. She's like, oh, my God, I got to get to the gift shop and get the kids Titanic T-shirts. What do you take, 2X or 3X? I'm like, if we don't make it to the lifeboat and you go to the gift shop, get me a life jacket any size. And, like, the end of the movie, Titanic, I would be Leonardo DiCaprio. She'd be Kate Winslet. She would be on top of that door, and I'd be like, ready to die. And the last thing I'm going to hear her say is, why is this smudge on the door? And I'm like, Anyway, during the pandemic, I binge-watched certain TV shows like everybody else. One of them was Everybody Loves Raymond. And I thought, you know, wouldn't it be great if they had a reunion special? Ray Romano said they don't want to touch a good thing. I disagree. I think they could have one more show. Figure it's like 20 years from now, Ray and Robert Barone retired in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and you go, hey, Raymond, you know, I was wondering, you think there's baseball in heaven?
You know, Robert, nobody ever asked me that question, but I'll tell you what, if I find out, I'll let you know, okay?
Thanks, Raymond. Thanks a lot. 6 months go by. Ray Barone drops dead of a heart attack. Robert's very depressed. Another year goes by. He's sitting in a dark room. Out of nowhere, he hears, Robert! Robert! Oh, my God, Raymond, is that you?
Yes, it's me. I'm calling you from the afterlife. I have good news and bad news to tell you.
Oh, my God.
First, the good news is there's baseball in heaven. The bad news is you're pitching next Thursday.
There am I. So I'm sad to say I made an investment. I just lost a lot of money. You heard of J-Date, right? This is called J-Porn. For instance, the first category is getting an estimate. And then you have a woman saying, "Ooh, you want to stick that where? Ain't going to happen." Another category was foreplay. It was just no sex, just a bunch of complaining and, you know, begging. And the last one I'll tell you about is, you know, you heard of sword swallowers. This is called Schmeckel kissers. It went, it's no longer around. So anyway, another show that I binge watch was that show Naked and Afraid. You remember that show? Mm-hmm. They should actually call it Naked and Naive, because 80% of the people that are on that show drink water without boiling it first. You know, how many people do that? I mean, it's amazing. It's astounding how many people do it. So anyway, I thought to myself, no Jewish guy would ever go on that show. First of all, he doesn't want to show his Schmeckel to the world. And secondly, you don't get paid any money. There's no prize. You just do it because you just do it because you could just last. That's not going to happen. Sorry. So anyway, do you ever notice, ever wonder what it would be like to meet your heroes? Sometimes we shouldn't meet our heroes because they're like, you know, they have human frailties like everybody else. I kind of figured, like, if Santa Claus was real, sorry, kids. if we could actually interview the real Santa Claus, it'd be like this. Okay, look, I don't got my costume on. You want to interview me? Fine. But if you take a picture of me, I'm going to punch you in the head. Yeah. Look, keep it moving, okay? You got to pay me cash at the end, all right? Hold on. Oh, what do you want to ask me? North Pole? You freeze your ass off up there. I have a sweatshop in Newark, New Jersey. I hire illegal immigrants. I feed them rice and beans. You got a problem with that? You figure out how to make 5 billion toys and deliver them in 24 hours. Hold on. I got a phone call. Hold on. Hey, Bambi, how you doing? Hey, yeah. I want that 1 hour session. I want you to tie me up and whip toys at me. And then I'm going to tap that ass. Ho, 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 yo. All right, this interview's over. Where's my cash? And lastly, back to the pandemic and binge washing. On Disney Plus, they have this show called Obi-Wan Kenobi. And you know what I love about the show? They bring back Darth Vader. I just can't get enough of Darth Vader. You know, what have we not seen Darth Vader do? We haven't seen him fornicate. So here's Darth Vader fornicating.
Bend over, bitch.
Though it's also an impression of me fornicating with my CPAP mask on. Thank you very much. I'm Eric Seltzer.
Really nice. Do you have another song for us?
Sure.
Okay. Cool. Raquel Rains, ladies and gentlemen.
Bring it up.
Yes.
Baby cried the day the circus came to town, 'cause she didn't want parades just passing by her. So she painted on a smile and took up with some clown, while she danced without a net up on the wire. I know a lot about her, 'cause you see, baby is an awful not like me. I told her, don't cry out loud, just keep it inside and learn how to hide your feelings. Fly high and proud, and if you should fall, remember you almost had it all. Baby saw that when they took that big top down, they left behind her dreams among the litter, and a different kind of love she thought she'd found. There was nothing left but sawdust and some glitter. But baby can't be broken, 'cause you see, she had the finest teacher, that was me. I told her, don't cry out loud, just keep it inside and learn how to hide your should fall. Remember, you almost had it all.
It's the end of the show.
Oh, no.
20 years in the books.
Wow, I'm sad it's over.
And we have a last song where everybody's going to come up and dance. All the comedians come up and dance. And Freddie, we have some sponsors. AJC Advisors.
Diddly.
D Bagel and Deli.
Diddly D Bagel and Deli. Hi.
Tobacco. Oriental Plaza. Oriental Plaza. They provided the Chinese food for tonight's show. Oriental Plaza.
Oriental Plaza. Yeah. Bella.
Beans Cafe.
Cafe.
Okay.
There it is. All right, it's Coney Island song, everybody. Sing it.